Subscribe and press the bell icon to never miss an update from First Post.
Hello and welcome to First Day First Showsha. I'm Deadpool and today I'm reviewing Deadpool 2.
Mr. Pool. Pool bhai. Maybe?
We're at Cannibal IMAX Wadala and we're going to review Deadpool 2 for you in 10 questions and 0 spoilers.
And no, Iron Man does not die in this film. Let's dive in.
What in the f**kicle is this?
Was Age of Ultron better than the first Avengers film? Was Doom 2 better than Doom? Well, let's just say that compared to the first Deadpool film, this one is a little extra in every possible way.
Doing the right thing is messy.
Humor is to Deadpool what avocados are to vegans. Basically, there's too much of it. Ignore the humor in the film and all you're left with is kale, spinach, chickpeas? I don't know. I mean, what do vegans even eat?
We're gonna form a super duper group. Need them tough, morally flexible, and young enough to carry their own franchise for 10 to 12 years.
Pop culture nerds are most likely to enjoy this film because of all those nods to Marvel, DC, Star Wars and whatnot. Hell, there's even a Shah Rukh Khan song in the film. Thank God there were no Krish references. So anyway, if you're not caught up with all of these universes, some things in the film are bound to fly over your head.
Domino, I'm lucky.
Luck isn't a superpower.
Yes, it is.
Like Deadpool, the character, the film is a relentless swear and go fest. It's campy and irreverent, just like Ranveer Singh on Coffee with Karan. Even if the film annoys you, it won't bore you. It's more LOL than Lamar. It's more Chandler Bing than Joey Tribbiani.
Problems? Okay. The contrived plot, the constant references, the repetitive breaking of the fourth wall. I mean, not only is Deadpool 2 a lot like Deadpool, but it'll also remind you of Avengers, Guardians of the Galaxy, and even this 2012 sci-fi film starring Joseph Gordon-Levitt. The first person to name that film in the comments is going to get a free screening of Bhavesh Joshi's Superhero.
Bring it on, One-Eyed Willie.
Nothing new. Next. I mean, it's fun, but so Sonu ki Titu ki Sweetie, right? Too soon? No? Okay.
It's showtime. Don't call it a comeback!
I've been here for years! Can you imagine Tony Stark without Robert Downey Jr.? Or Wolverine without Hugh Jackman? Or Batman without his deep, dark existential crisis? Well, Ryan Reynolds is the heart and soul of Deadpool 2. Having said that, what sort of a question is how is Ryan Reynolds? Ask Blake Lively.
My name's Cable. Here for the kid.
What? The kid?
Move or die.
I must say, Cable makes for a great character. And Josh Brolin's tough deadpan expressions are a good counter to Ryan Reynolds' pretty Deadpool face. I'm like a monsoon. Listen
to the bass drum. Tell me they got that in slow motion.
Firstly, you should be sitting through the end credits of all films. Filmmaking is not an easy job. And it wouldn't hurt to sit through those names. And secondly, hell yeah. In fact, for me, the best part of Deadpool 2 were the end credit scenes.
Peter.
Any power you want to tell us about?
I don't have one. I just saw the ad.
You're in.
So what's the rating of the film?
Well, it's 2.5 for me. Good fun, but jokes can only take you so far. What about you?
It's a 2.5 for me as well. I mean, which desi names that kid Dopinder? What's wrong with Appu?
Lots. That's it for the Deadpool 2 review. We'll be back with yet another First Day First Showsha soon. Bye-bye.
So we're heading towards another nail-biting finish. 5 runs to win off the last ball.
I tell you, things are getting steamier down there.
You mean stormier, Sonny. After all, gale forces at the crease.
Yes, Manu. He must win it for Kings da Punjab today.
But don't forget who has the ball in hand.
And here comes Budgie.
Pow! And Gill hits the ball in the air.
It's not good. Live the excitement of every ball, no matter where you are. Only on firstpost.com.